Remember this scene? It was just several months ago that a major ice storm left the Jackson community without power for days. Consumers Energy is hoping to avoid a repeat scenario with a push for more underground power lines. News 10's Riley Connell shows us where this project is headed and how customers say underground lines could impact them.
We've had family friends for 3 or 4 days that are without heat in the middle of winter, and that's super scary and not fun.
The voices of Consumers Energy customers have been heard. After a number of lengthy outages this year, the Michigan power supplier could be going underground to keep it from happening again.
So we've been hearing a lot from our customers about wanting a stronger power grid, a more reliable power grid. And one of the things that we can do, one of the tools that we can use to build a more reliable power grid, is burying power lines underground.
The outline for a pilot project is currently in the hands of the Michigan Public Service Commission. If it's approved, Consumers Energy can start looking for the best, most cost-effective way to get lines underground. Officials say the change would protect lines from power outage risk.
So when we have thunderstorms that roll through in the summer with 60 to 70 mile an hour wind gusts, or we have ice storms like the one we saw earlier this year, when those things happen, they can cause trees to come down on the lines, resulting in power outages.
Customers like Richard Johnson are eager to see the project put into motion.
Considering that we do have so much going on in the downtown area, and I believe that once it's done, it would be a lot more efficient and better for everybody.
Consumers Energy is anticipating a $4 million price tag on its pilot program, but if all goes according to plan, customers won't see rates rise. In Jackson, Riley Connell, News 10.
Consumers Energy says it's expecting a response to its proposal from the Michigan Public Service Commission by the end of this year.